GLB expert tips and tricks. To ensure the same experience on every device, MyAR Studio supports only the common features between each platform, web, Android, iOS. Refer to the following to optimize the GLB export of your scenes for use in augmented reality. Although in this video we will be using Blender, the concept expressed apply to any other 3D editor. Geometry. Each mesh can have only one UV set. In case of multiple UV sets, only the first one is used. It is not possible to bind data to vertices, so neither vertex color nor vertex animation are supported, also known as morph targets, blend shapes, shape keys. It is possible to instantiate the same geometry to save weight in the export file. Each instance can have its own independent animation. In augmented reality, the objects are positioned using the lowest point of the bounding box, which contains all the geometry of the scene. Pay attention that on Android and Chrome, only the bounding box of the first animation frame is considered, while on iOS, the bounding box of the entire animation is taken into account. In case of suspended objects, place an object at ground level to lower the base of the bounding box. To hide it, just shrink it without making it go to zero. The visibility flag of the objects are not exported in GLB. To make an object appear or disappear, just scale it from 0 to 100% in the space of a frame. Materials. Only one material per object must be used. Multiple objects can share the same material. Multiple instances of the same object can each use a different material. Supported texture formats are JPEG and PNG. No other image formats, animated texture or video files can be used. The parameters of a material and the texture mapping coordinates are not animatable. Not all material types are always exportable to GLB. For example, in Blender, it is always necessary to use the principal shader. Any other shader, for example diffuse, glossy, volume, will be ignored in the export phase. Refer to the documentation of your software to verify the compatibility of the materials with the GLB standard. Rigging. It is possible to use only one skeleton with only one associated mesh. Each vertex can be deformed by up to 4 bones, the remaining bones are ignored. The mesh associated with the skeleton will be deformed with linear interpolation. It may be necessary to use support bones to best deform the joints of organic characters. The mesh can be deformed by non-uniformly scaled bones. Animation. It is recommended to set the animation frame rate to 30 frames per second to synchronize the frames with the screen refresh rate of most phones. It is possible to export the animation at a lower frame rates, for example 24 frames per second. But, since the refresh rate will remain at 30 frames per second, some flickering or unwanted interpolation may occur. The beginning and end of an animation will coincide with the first and last exported keyframe. To have moments of pause at the beginning or end of the animation, just duplicate the initial or final keyframes and create the necessary space. Android and iOS might calculate keyframes interpolation differently. To keep the result as faithful as possible to the original, it will be necessary to bake the animation tracks when exporting to GLB. Baking will also be necessary when using constraints or driven objects. GLB format does not support particle systems. Refer to the documentation of the software used for the eventual conversion of particles into animated objects. To export multiple animated objects to a GLB file, make sure to export a single global animation track, rather than multiple independent tracks for each object. Export settings may vary depending on the software used. For example, in Blender, it's necessary to disable Group by NLA track. Thanks for watching this video tutorial. I remind you to subscribe to our channel not to lose any news, and I invite you to watch our videos for more information about MyAR Studio.